Joining us now is the Liverpool MP Ian Byrne, who has put forward an EDM, an early day motion, asking Parliament to recognise the work of fans within their local communities. And Ian joins us now. Ian, thank you for your time, sir. I know you've been well impressed by the activities of fans through lockdown and even before that as well. First and foremost, can I get your thoughts on that headline figure we brought people on Monday? More than 100 tonnes of supplies collected by fans this season alone, despite all the issues that came about as a result of the lockdown.
No, it's usually impressive, Mick, isn't it? And it's a real national effort. People from across the country in many communities, and football fans have really come to the fore during the COVID crisis and helped out the communities in such a way which has been quite awe-inspiring. And, you know, hopefully people will recognise the importance of football fans and the good that they can do for communities, as we've been doing for a long time in Liverpool.
Absolutely. And in terms of that as well, it has been a national effort. You know, you guys in Liverpool with Liverpool and Everton collections have really led the way. But actually, you've had and inspired various different supporters groups up and down the country to do the same, and not just in the Premier League, in the Football League and beyond.
Oh, absolutely. I think that's a really important point. It's not just Premier League focused. It's all pyramids of the Football League. We get lots and lots of help from many non-league clubs in Liverpool who've been magnificent right throughout, and I'm sure that's replicated throughout the country. But, you know, it's one of our finest achievements with Fans Support and Food Bank, is bringing football groups together. And, you know, nothing gives us greater pleasure than to see Manchester United, Manchester City working collaboratively with Liverpool, Newcastle, West Ham. You know, I think it's a brilliant achievement, and it's what's going to be needed post-COVID, Mick.
Just tell us about the early day motion for people who don't understand the sort of the workings of Parliament. How does the EDM work?
Well, I submitted it yesterday, and other MPs can co-sign. And it's basically just a recognition of thanks for the efforts that have been made from football supporters throughout the communities. I thought it was important that we put it in within the parliamentary structure, and people and MPs could pay thanks to the people in their communities that have helped out. And I just think it's a tribute to all the people involved that have done so much good work during COVID. And, you know, it's a recognition from Parliament, and it's something which I'm proud to have created, and I'm sure many people will sign.
Absolutely. And I've been so impressed as well by, and when we put forward and gave you the evidence that we'd collected, we're having to miss people off, because if we actually put the full list of everything that people were doing and achieving, there wouldn't be enough space on the early day motion to actually put it forward. You know, the efforts of people in England, Scotland, across the whole of the United Kingdom is genuinely impressive.
Yeah, massively so, and I found it extremely difficult. I only had 250 words, so I'm sure there's people who aren't on it, and, you know, we can only apologise regards that. But it was just to try and focus on the efforts that we know we've been involved in, you know, certainly from Fan Support and Food Bank's perspective, so I can speak with validity on their efforts, and just recognise the groups that have come together over the last 4 months and gone out into the communities and filled gaps which have been left. And, you know, I think it's from food to obviously the PPE effort that was done in Liverpool from Merseyside PPE, which has just been magnificent, you know. And I think that's important, that it's recognised, it's important that people realise the solidarity that came from the city that went right out across the country. And also people give up the time and their efforts. And, you know, I think if you speak to people that have been involved in these efforts, I think it's really helped them as well through the COVID period mentally. It's given them focus, and it's given them something to, you know, to do positively during this period, which has been really, really difficult for so many people, Mick.
Let's just focus on the work in Scotland, and there have been different sort of needs in different parts of the United Kingdom. In Scotland, fans not just supporting their local communities and the vulnerable within, you know, their own neighbourhoods, but physically, financially supporting their football clubs as well. That just goes to show the pride and passion of Scottish football fans.
No, absolutely. You know, and what they've done there is appreciate the importance of football to the communities and come together. And I think, you know, listening to some of the meetings we've been in the last couple of weeks, you know, I think football across Europe is going to face the same issues, isn't it? Certainly across the world as well. But certainly locally, clubs are going into difficulty now. So it is going to need possibly state intervention if I'm honest, to keep the football pyramid alive. But what Scotland fans have shown there is you'd expect it because they love the game, it's the national game, but it's a magnificent effort and you've got to applaud them. And, you know, we've got to have a football from grassroots to the Premier League. We've got to have it to survive when we come out of this, because obviously it brings so much joy, pleasure and health benefits and everything else with it mixed. So we've got to all work collectively to ensure that football and all sports are still there once we come out of this, because, you know, everyone's struggling across the board, aren't they, regarding this. But yeah, it's important moving forward, and I've got to applaud the Scottish fans for that, yeah.
In terms of that, I mean, it's so interesting to see as we prioritise our lives in different ways through coronavirus and COVID-19, how football has been able to play a part. You know, we've called this more than just a game, because we found, you know, evidence that, you know, even though the game's not been played since, you know, mid-March for large parts of the country, the return of the Premier League that we've seen now, of course, football and the brand of football clubs' names, the passion of supporters, has actually garnered people's enthusiasm and supported people through this time as well. That's a really powerful thing that shouldn't be underestimated, should it?
No, absolutely. You know, we've always said the power of football is immense across all communities, isn't it? And we've used it quite powerfully from fan support Vubank perspective to go into places where we never thought we would and influence people who we never thought we'd influence. And, you know, I think moving forward, football is going to have a huge role in making sure the society that we enter will be cohesive, working together collaboratively. And I think we can really use football as a vehicle to do that, Mick. And, you know, it's something we've always aspired to do. It's something we continue to aspire to do. And hopefully communities recognise the importance that football supporters can play, the football clubs can play. And as I say, we'll all have a part collectively working together to make sure that we live in a more equal society. But at the moment, obviously, it's all hands to the pump. Regarding, as you mentioned, fundraising to keep football clubs alive, you know, it's feeding communities, PPE in communities. So, you know, it's probably something that we never thought we'd be speaking about from a football fan's perspective, Mick, what I've just outlined. But, you know, we're in extraordinary times. We've been in difficult times for the last 10 years. And, you know, football supporters have come to the fore, and long may that continue, because we've got a hugely important role to play in society.
Is that why campaigns like More Than Just a Game are so important, to remind people that football fans can absolutely be a force for good at a time where it's easy just to go back to old-fashioned stereotypes about what football fans are like?
No, absolutely. I think the More Than Just a Game is a really, really good headline, because we haven't had the game, have we, for 4 months as such, and we've just gone out there as football supporters, as a valuable part of the community, and done what we've had to do. But, you know, as we move into getting the game back that we love, you know, and being able to play the game again, and, you know, it brings so much joy to so many in the community, and I think that can never, ever be forgotten. And also, I think what this has done is for people who sometimes become a little blasé about the game, you know, I think it's give everyone a taste of what we've actually got, what we've missed, and, you know, how we can build back better moving forward.
And back to your early day motion, do you hope that it might get picked up, that you can have those conversations within the corridors of power, and indeed that you'll get a response from government, hopefully, who will recognise some of the evidence that we've helped you put forward?
Yeah, I think it will be interesting, you know, if we get some cross-party support from it, which I'm sure we will. And it's just, you know, it's just an acknowledgement, you know, at the end I've said this is the true face of football supporters, and thanks for all the solidarity shown. And I think that message is absolutely key moving forward. And that's what I wanted to emphasise, you know, the true face of football supporters is what we've seen over the last 4 months.
Ian Byrne, thank you so much for your time. Thanks for joining us on the programme.
Thank you, Mick. Great to speak to you.